Postgraduate Department of Studies and Commerce, I, Karthika M. Gujral, cordially welcome you all to the National Level Postgraduate Commerce and Management Fest, Magnum 2018. I request our student coordinators, Mr. Rajat Kumar N.S., Mr. Aldrin Melbert D'Souza, and Ms. Pradna Yogesh Bhatt to escort the dignitaries on the dais. So today, in this auspicious occasion, I welcome Professor B.S. Nagendra Prakash, Registrar, Bangalore University, and the President of this program, accompanied by Dr. Priya Ballal, the Chief Guest, Director of Vijaya Clinic and Head Dog Diagnologist Department of KMC Hospital, Mangaluru, Mr. Amrit Shenai, the Guest of Honor, Proprietor, Sri Lakshmi Homes and Infrastructure, Udupi, and also the Academic Council Member of Bangalore University, Professor Ishwara P., Chairman and Dean, Department of Studies and Commerce, Mangalore University, Mr. Abhinandan Kulal and Ms. Deepthi, Faculty Coordinator to Magnum 2018, a national level postgraduate commerce and management fest. It is the mark of our undying tradition to invoke the Almighty at the blessing of an important event. As a great philosopher, Swain Kierkegaard said, "The function of the prayer is not to influence God, but rather to change the nature of one who prays." Thus, I like to call upon Chaitra and group to invoke God's blessings on us all. We feel blessed indeed. I invite the student president of Commerce Association, Mr. Rajat Kumar N.S., to formally welcome the gathering.
Sunshine is a welcome spark that brings a lot of brightness. A very good morning to one and all gathered here. On behalf of the Commerce Association, it's my proud pleasure to extend a grateful welcome for the inaugural function of Magnum 2018. Firstly, I would like to introduce the today's chief guest, Dr. Priya Ballal. Dr. Priya Ballal has completed her MBBS, MT degree from KMC, Mangalore. Currently, she is working as a professor and HOD of Gynecology Department of KMC. She has done lots of research works in the field of maternal and fetal medicine. She has been awarded Distinguished Alumni Award by KMC in the year 2010 and also Dr. Patrick Pinto Memorial Best Teacher Award in the year 2012. She is one of the member of the Indian Medical Association and Federation of Gynecology Societies of India. She is also a good dancer, musician and sportsperson. We are happy to have such a talented and resourceful person with us today. On behalf of management, staff and student of Department of Studies in Commerce, I extend a very warm welcome to you, ma'am. And I would like to introduce today's guest of honor, Mr. Amrit Shenai. Mr. Amrit Shenai, a youth leader who has actively involved in the social work since two decades. He supported drama, singing, sports and cultural activity. He has been awarded Bharat Jyoti Award and Konkani Academy Award for the tremendous contribution in the field of social work. He was the academic member of the Mangalore University as well. So we are very lucky to have you with us here today. On behalf of management, staff, student of Department of Studies in Commerce, we extend a very warm welcome to you, sir. We have with us one more renowned personality, Dr. B.S. Nagendra Prakash, Registrar of Mangalore University. Dr. Nagendra Prakash, a professor in the Department of Civil Engineering, JP Campus, Mangalore. He has a key interest in the research field and he is a guiding of many PhD and MBA students. He has published many publications in national and international journals. Respected sir, we are very blessed to have you with us here today. On behalf of the management staff and students of Department of Studies in Commerce, we welcome you, sir. I also extend a hearty welcome to the Chairman and Dean, Department of Studies in Commerce, Professor Ishwar Appi. Welcome you, sir. Now I take a pleasure to welcome our staff coordinators, Mr. Abhinandan and Ms. Deepthi, to this occasion. Welcome you both. I extend my warm welcome to the student coordinators of Commerce Association, Mr. Aldrin Melbert D'Souza and Ms. Pradnya Yogesh Bhatt. Welcome you. Now I take opportunity to welcome all the invitees, teaching and non-teaching staff, research scholars, media friends and also participants from different colleges. Welcome you all. And I wholeheartedly welcome all my dear members of Commerce Associations. Welcome, welcome. Thank you.
I request Professor Ishwara P. to give a floral accord to Professor B.S. Nagendra Prakash, Registrar, Mangalore University. Thank you, sir. I request Professor B.S. Nagendra Prakash to florally welcome Dr. Priya Ballal, the chief guest of today's function. Once again, I request Professor B.S. Nagendra Prakash to give a floral welcome to Mr. Ambit Chennai. Thank you, sir. Now I request Mr. Abhinandan Kulal to florally accord Professor Ishwara P., Chairman and Dean, Department of Studies and Commerce, Mangalore University. Thank you, sir. I request Mr. Rajat Kumar N.S. to florally welcome Mr. Abhinandan Kulal, Faculty Coordinator of Commerce Association, Mangalore University. Thank you, Rajat. Now I call upon Mr. Aldrin Melbert D'Souza to give a floral welcome to Ms. Deepthi, Faculty Coordinator of Commerce Association, Mangalore University. Thank you, Aldrin. Now I request Mr. Sunil B.L., Secretary of Student Council, to welcome Mr. Rajat Kumar N.S., the Student President of Commerce Association. I request Mr. Deekshit B.R., the event coordinator of Magnum 2018, to florally welcome Mr. Aldrin Melbert D'Souza, the student secretary of Commerce Association. And here I call upon Ms. Kavishree H.N. to welcome Ms. Pradnya Yogesh Bhatt, the treasurer of Commerce Association. Thank you, Kavya. Learning leads to creativity. Creativity leads to thinking. Thinking provides knowledge and knowledge makes you great, said Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam. Competitions like this provide us an opportunity to learn, to be creative, to think and gain knowledge and ultimately be great with substance. The postgraduate commerce talent among students. Now, I request Professor Ishwara P., Chairman and Dean, 2017, Department of Studies in Commerce, Mangalore University, to give a brief introduction of Magnum 2018.
Honorable Registrar of our universities, Professor B.S. Nagendra Prakash sir, distinguished chief guest, Dr. Priya Ballal, Director of Vijay Clinic and HOD in KMC Hospital, Mangalore. Our respected guest of honor, Amrit Shane sir, proprietary, Sri Lakshmi Home and Infrastructure Udupi. Esteemed colleagues in the department, faculties from other departments, research scholars, staff coordinators, Abhinandan sir and Deepthi ma'am, student coordinators, Rajat Kumar NS, Alden D'Souza, Pragna Bhatt, office staff, team members from various colleges and universities, friends from media, and my dear student friends. At the very outset, I would like to extend heartily welcome to all the members, teams, participants, and faculties from various colleges and universities. So, coming from different colleges and universities for this Commerce and Management Fest, a mega event, Magnum 2018. The Mangalore University offers M.Com courses in more than 35 colleges, and above 1,300 students are registered for M.Com degree in Mangalore University in these colleges on regular basis. At the same time, an equal number of students also registered under the Directorate of Distance Education in Mangalore University. So the main campus, sir, Mangala Gangotri, there are more than 300 students pursuing M.Com third course in three batches, and also we have around 105 research scholars registered for their doctoral degree in the Department of Commerce. So therefore, the Department of Commerce in the main campus is one of the biggest department in terms of the students enrollment. Our students in the Department of Commerce, Mangalore University, have been organizing Commerce and Management Fest for the last 12 years under the brand name of Magnum Beyond the Horizon. It is our 13th edition. It is one of the very successful flagship program, not only in the Department of Commerce, but also in the entire university. Every year, our students organize Commerce and Management Fest. So this time, we have received an overwhelming response, not only from the colleges and the universities of the Karnataka state, but also we have received response from other states like Andhra, Tamil Nadu, Kerala, etc. So the Magnum is a Commerce and Management Fest. So it provides a platform for all the participants to showcase their talents, their knowledge in various commerce and management related events like Best Manager event, Business Quiz event, some of the events relating to the entrepreneurship development programs, and some of the events related to the finance, marketing, HR, etc., etc. So participation in these events, it is really helpful to our students in imbibing the spirit of teamwork, creative learning, critical thinking, decision making, moreover, getting exposure to the realities of business world. So inside the classroom, on the one hand, we teach our students the regular theoretical subjects with the touch of recent developments in the field of commerce and management. We teach our students the developments in the accounting, finance, HR, marketing, etc., etc. So therefore, we provide our students with strong theoretical knowledge. On the other hand, we encourage our students to participate in the group discussion, case study analysis, simulation exercise, role play. We also encourage our students to undertake the project reports and also to participate in the internship training program. And thus, on the other hand, we make an earnest attempt to provide our students a strong practical exposure. So in this direction, Magnum is one kind of a simulation experiment that can go a long way in boosting the self-confidence and enhancing the employable skill of our commerce and management students. In the present employment scenario, as we know that the artificial intelligence, cloud computing, automation, big data analytics, robots are expected to take over the employment opportunities of the commerce and management graduates. Therefore, there is an urgent need for reskill and upskill of the commerce and management graduates. In this context, our students have chosen the right theme for the Magnum 2018, that is, namely, Dawn of an Entrepreneur's Province. The real entrepreneur is a doer and not a dreamer. Don't just dream your dreams, make them reality by planning for them and working for them. If you can dream it, you can do it. Without ambition, one starts nothing, and without work, one finishes nothing. So the Magnum 2018, so there are more than 25 teams have already registered in different events. So these teams coming from different colleges, different universities, and different states. So therefore, during these 2 days, all these members, you are in Bangalore University campus. I appeal all the members, all the participants who are coming from different colleges and universities, I appeal all the participants and team members, they uphold the dignity and decorum of Bangalore University with your discipline while enjoying the ambience of Bangalore University. With these few words, I wish Magnum 2018 a grand success. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir. Asatoma Sadgamaya, Tamasoma Jyotirgamaya, Mrityoma Amritangamaya. A ray of light, it is a ray of hope. Let's all leave the darkness and step towards the right path. Now, we shall have our traditional auspicious lamp lighting ceremony as a tribute to Mother Saraswati, the goddess of knowledge. Now I request all the dignitaries to light the lamp and symbolically inaugurate Magnum 2018. On this event.
Respected dignitaries on the dais, student representatives, faculty in the audience, students, and members of Bangalore University. It has been honestly a lovely morning and a wonderful opportunity to be here and spend time with all of you in the Bangalore University. I'm overwhelmed, and I should thank all of you for having me here. It is an honor. When your student representatives came and met me, I was asking them why me and what I'm supposed to do here. So they said, you need to inspire the students. My job is pretty easy, I feel, because everybody here looks very much inspired and very enthusiastic to take on the world. That's how it looks. So I congratulate and wish all the participants of today who have come here to show their talent, their prowess in their field. I usually am addressing students of medicine. Very rarely I get to address students of commerce. So, but anyway, students everywhere are the same. They need that little push in the right direction. So, your fest starts today, and the one who succeeds, or not only in the fest, even in real life, is somebody who nurtures or is capable of lateral thinking. When we say lateral thinking, we mean something out of the ordinary, right? And most of the lateral thinking, or thinking out of the ordinary or out of the box, what you call, comes from, of course, some are inborn with that talent, and it is possible to nurture lateral thinking. Science says so. And most of the creativity and lateral thinking comes from the right half of the brain. Okay? All of us who are right-handed, all of you know, have the left hemisphere of our brain as dominant hemisphere. It looks after basically everything that we do in our day-to-day life. But what does the right half of the brain do then? The right half of the brain basically is the creative part of the brain. The one that brings out music, the one that brings out paintings, creativity, designs, graphics. These all come from the right half of the brain. Stories, fiction, they all come from the right half. So they say that the further or the more you nurture the right half of the brain, the left half also seems to be more and more efficient. So my advice to you is to always have something to stimulate right half of the brain. Create a hobby. It may be sport, it may be music, it may be dance, it may be anything that improves creativity. And it is also said that an efficient brain is one which is relaxed, which is de-stressed. So all of us, you dear students, I'm sure you all feel that exams, projects, assignments are the biggest stress in the world. Least did I know that was the easiest part of my life. The minute I finished college and stepped out, I realized every day is an exam in its own. And every day brings its own challenges. Every new patient brings its own challenge. Every difficult student brings its own challenge. So overcoming these challenges leads to a lot of stress over the day. And I feel it's very important to find a hobby or to find a method of relaxation so that the next day you're still fresh and you will be able to deal with challenges that come your way without too much of fluster. Is there no time? That is what all of us say. I don't have the time. I wish I could learn music. I don't have the time. I wish I could go to the gym. I need some exercise. I don't have the time. So I think all of you management students, I'm sure, are taught time management. As medical graduates, we are not taught time management. Somehow we are thrown into the deep end and we learn time management on our own. So managing time becomes very, very important. And it is said that the mind is most relaxed either just before you fall asleep or as soon as you wake up in the morning. That's when you get your best ideas. That is what it said. Or when you relax your mind. When you listen to music, when you play music, when you nurture a hobby, when you exercise, when you run, that's when your mind is relaxed. So you're stressed out, you need a good idea, you need to run, exercise, jog, and most importantly, sleep well. I'm sure some of you students sleep more than required, but ideally, about 6 to 8 hours of sleep is what is supposed to keep the mind alert. When you lose sleep, no matter, suppose you cram before your exam, you study all night. How many hours did you sleep? I slept only 2 hours. Oh my God, that means she studied more than me. How many hours did you sleep? I didn't sleep at all. Oh sheesh, what am I going to do? I slept for 6 hours. But believe me, the person who has had a good night's sleep is the one who's going to have his thoughts clear in the exam, is the one who's going to do well in the exam. So a good sleep before your stressful day is very, very important. And that is when your mind is relaxed and more active and more alert to take on the next day. Mind you, I just said 6 to 8 hours of sleep. Please don't come late for the next day morning lecture and said, Priya ma'am said, to sleep a lot, okay? I didn't say a lot, I said adequate. So, time management is what I was talking about, and I feel that Multitasking has become the realm of the day. While you're sitting here, you're answering emails, you're talking to somebody else in the other half of the globe, you're planning, you're deciding, and sometimes you're even socializing. But it is important to prioritize. For example, a doctor can't be sitting on her phone when you have a patient in front of you. You cannot be multitasking when you have an important decision to take. So there is etiquette, there is a place for everything. But in all this multitasking, it is important to multitask in the sense that you need to balance your time for everything. Balance your career with your family life. Balance your own health with your career. It becomes very important, especially for women. Women are empowered in most of the country. The others are on the path of empowerment, and I am very proud to see a lot of women in this audience, and I'm very happy that women empowerment is happening everywhere. I'm sure we are shoulder to shoulder in any path that we take, but we must remember that the mother is closest to the child. The mother has the additional responsibility of looking after the next generation. Of course, fathers have their influence. My father had a big influence on me. He's my role model. But our mothers are the ones, I feel, who put the basic personality and the basic perspectives in place. So if we are to be good mothers, we are the ones to shape the next generation. So what bigger empowerment do you want? Women empowerment starts from being a mother. And I think that's the most important role that a woman has to play. The rest of them, of course, we have shown that we can and we will continue to be equal and more. Having said that, I was talking about multitasking, and what I want to say is there are a lot of achievers who have done more than two things. How many of you all have seen the movie Jurassic Park? Very good. So do you know the author of that movie is a doctor? He's a Harvard graduate, right? If you look at the field of Olympics, there was an Olympic medalist, a swimmer. Her name was Jean something. She's an anesthetist. Alright? So there are a lot of people who have multitasks and attained a lot of things other than what they were trained to do. So my advice to you, think out of the box, nurture your creativity, get into the competition, believe in yourself, succeed with ethical values. Thank you very much for this lovely opportunity.
Thank you so much, ma'am, for your inspirable words. Every effort has to be recognized and every winning is symbolized. Magnum is the effort of Department of Commerce, Mangalore University, and the participants who will ultimately win this war of talent shall take the memory of their winning. If a black lady symbolizes Oscar and the golden peacock symbolizes corporate excellence, in the same way, we have our unique symbolical representation of Magnum 2018, and they are the crystal shining trophies. We now have a very unique ceremony of unveiling the trophies for you, the August gathering. As we have the event coordinators, Mr. Deekshit B.R. and Ms. Kavishri H.N., followed by the event heads, entering into this hall with respective trophies, let us all give them a thunderous applause.
She inspired you all. She inspired all these people sitting on the dais also. Oh. So one big round of applause for her. So, when I am introduced here, they told I am a youth leader. I am neither youth nor senior. I am somewhere in between that. You have to decide, looking at me, whether I am youth or not. Black and white is here. Both are here. What do you call me? You have to decide. Our registrar has to find a new word for people like me. In what category I belong, I really don't know. Youngsters also like me, seniors also love me. So, in few years I'll be old. I will not be youth. So I have seen, from past 15 years, I address students. Every other day I also speak, like this, I address big, small gatherings. So I have seen most of the students are not comfortable with the English because their mother tongue is Kannada, Tulu, or here Konkani. So since what I wanted to share here and I am going to share is an elaboration of the what doctor spoke before me, she shared with you. So which language do you prefer, Kannada or English? English, raise your hands. Kannada. Now I am confused. Okay. I will start what she told with the small story, which is a real story, not a created one. Okay, I will reveal my age. Don't be under confusion. I am 40 now. When I was 25, I was comparatively, I did not achieve anything. Now I have achieved something in my business, social activities, and I have been awarded in various places for my activities. But in those days, I was struggling. But I decided to marry a girl. Because if I had not decided, she would not have waited for me. Her parents were very much in hurry. If I denied, I would have to marry someone else. I don't know who were ready in those days. So I decided to marry her. And when I invited my friend, he was my classmate and he was also a same, he was 26, I was also 26. Then he shouted on me. He said, Kannada valli, ninge tale sari ilva. Are you mad you are going to marry? What you have achieved in life? Do you have any property with you? Do you have flat, car, job, nothing? You are struggling. Don't marry now. See, I will achieve so many things in life. I want to buy a flat in Bangalore. I want to create a property for myself, my future. I have to achieve something in my professional life. Then I will marry. You do whatever you want. He did not attend my marriage. It is not a joke. He was very much angry on me. Maybe he was jealous, I don't know. But he did not attend my marriage. I am happy married person now. I have two kids. And I am okay with my achievement. I am not achieved, I don't know, there is no precise measurement for achievement, but I am happy. As the madam told, I get good sleep. That is the measurement of happiness, if I am not wrong.
Good measurement.
And I also created some property, earned good name, I am doing something in my life. And that friend also achieved so many things. He reached more heights which he was dreaming in those days. He bought 4 flats in Mumbai and Bangalore. I know. Recently he bought 1 flat. He created property. He got 3 promotions. He is 40 and now he is searching for a girl. Just because he has 4 flats and he is a very big officer in a private company and earning lakhs of lakhs rupees, anyone is ready to marry him? Girls? No. So this is the reality of life which doctor wanted to convey you. You achieve the success, but not at the cost of your happiness. Not at the cost of the talents what given by God to you. You dance, you sing. See, that doctor is a right example. When she was introduced, I clapped. When I came to know that, she is not only a doctor, she is a singer and dancer. Now we have to clap again. Taking along everything what God has given us and reaching a target is an achievement. Leaving behind our friends, leaving behind our all the enjoyments, pleasure of watching movies, pleasure of shopping, enjoying with the kids, dancing, What is the achievement? What is the use of that achievement when you don't have friends to share your joy of that achievement? One thing I would like to differ with the doctor is, we get good sleep before the exam only when we are prepared. We are not prepared, that is why we don't sleep. Do you agree on that? So this is what I wanted to convey. Set an academic goal. You want to become doctor, you want to become chartered accountant or some businessman, industrialist, entrepreneur, registrar, doctor. Set that goal. Have you heard race with that lemon on spoon? Yeah, that lemon is the things you have to carry while you finish the race. The lemon is your joy, your relation, your talents, your sleep, your watching movies, your taste. Everything you have to carry with you. Life is not a simple race. You have to carry everything with you and become a doctor, but don't stop dancing and don't stop singing. We have a Jwalanta example here on the dais. I am really happy to share dais with such a person. And I was a member of academic council here. From past 3 years, I have been attending every meeting, and I myself declare that I was the most active participant. Am I wrong?
No, sir, right.
No, okay. Because I used to indulge in the discussions, debates. If a VC is here, he would have agreed my views, because whenever I stand up, he becomes alert in the meeting. Because I raise genuine issues related to students, related to academics, syllabus, and a couple of days back, I was sitting on the same dais for that convocation. I became very emotional because I have to, you know, my term is over now. I am not a member today. But after a few days, when these people came to me, they also told me the same thing, to inspire. But that doctor is already inspired you all, and I also added some points to that. So I am really attached to this university, because when I was in college, I had so many things in my mind. You will laugh now, one desire of mine was I wanted to become a model. I wanted to become movie star, I wanted to become minister, I wanted to become so many things, but I have never dreamt that I would become a member of Senate here, because I was very weak in academic matters. But God realized my dream. I didn't dream, but God gave me an opportunity to become a part of this great university. Maybe my other good deeds he must have recognized. So I will ever cherish the moments I spent in Mangalore University. I don't know what I will become in future, but this membership of Academic Council is the greatest privilege for me ever I got in my life. That is why I am here today. Otherwise, time never permits me to travel 1.5 hours here and spending whole day here. I have to do a lot of activities. So I am very emotionally connected to this university. I will keep coming here. I will be in touch with registrar, because people of Udupi don't know that, and they will not agree that I am not a Senate member. Every day they come to me regarding their convocation certificate, their attendance shortage, their mark card issues, so many issues they come here. Now I will keep calling you all, not for my personal work. I am always with the students and people. So sorry, I have not told how long I have to speak here. I have a bad habit that if I get mic, It is very difficult to stop me. Don't worry, I will stop now. So I wish you all the best. And this event, I have not spoken about this. Finally, I would like to say that today's world is very stressful world and very competitive. Simply having a gold medal in MCOM, MBA will not help you. You understand this fact better. Simply having a highest distinction marks will not help you to become successful in your life. You have to learn how to manage the time, how to speak, how to represent yourself, how to dress, how to smile, how to communicate effectively. Then only big corporate companies will give you a job, or you will be able to become successful in your whole entrepreneurship, own industries, whatever you do. So all these things your teachers will not teach you. All these things you can practice in participating in such events. So I congratulate the organizers of this event, because you are giving a platform to the students to become, you know, more nurtured and more polished. So I congratulate all of you to be a part of this great ceremony. I again thank the organizers and everyone who gave me opportunity. Thank you. God bless you all.
Extremely honored we are to have our Registrar of Mangalore University, Professor B.S. Nagendra Prakash, as the president of this program. He being a renowned academician and a researcher par excellence, he is also a guiding light to all the endeavors of this university. Respected sir, we are most eagerly awaiting for your presidential address.
ಎಲ್ಲರಿಗೂ ಮುಂಜಾನೆಯ ಶುಭ ಹಾರೈಕೆಗಳೊಂದಿಗೆ ಇಂದಿನ ಕೇಂದ್ರ ಬಿಂದುಗಳಾಗಿರತಕ್ಕಂಥ ಡಾಕ್ಟರ್ ಪ್ರಿಯಾ ಬಳ್ಳಾಳವರೇ, ಮಾಜಿ ಅಕಾಡೆಮಿಕ್ ಕೌನ್ಸಿಲ್ ಸದಸ್ಯರಾಗಿರ್ತಕ್ಕಂಥ ಅಮೃತ್ ಶನಾಯರವರೇ, ವಾಣಿಜ್ಯ ವಿಭಾಗದ ಮುಖ್ಯಸ್ಥರು ಹಾಗೂ ಡೀನ್ರಾಗಿರ್ತಕ್ಕಂಥ ನನ್ನ ಆತ್ಮೀಯ ಸಹೋದ್ಯೋಗಿಗಳಾಗಿರ್ತಕ್ಕಂಥ ಈಶ್ವರರವರೇ, ವೇದಿಕೆ ಮುಂದೆ ಇರತಕ್ಕಂಥ ನನ್ನ ಇತರೆ ಸಹ ಪ್ರಾಧ್ಯಾಪಕರು ಅಧ್ಯಾಪಕರು ಆಗಿರ್ತಕ್ಕಂಥ ಎಲ್ಲ ನನ್ನ ಮಿತ್ರರೇ, ವೇದಿಕೆ ಮೇಲೆ ಉಪಸ್ಥಿತಿರ್ತಕ್ಕಂಥ ನನ್ನ ಯುವ ಫ್ಯಾಕಲ್ಟಿ ಕೋಆರ್ಡಿನೇಟರ್ ಆಗಿರ್ತಕ್ಕಂಥ ಅಭಿನಂದನ್ ಕುಲಾಲ್ ಅವರೇ, ದೀಪ್ತಿ ಅವರೇ, ವಿದ್ಯಾರ್ಥಿ ಮಿತ್ರ ಕೋಆರ್ಡಿನೇಟರ್ಸ್ ಆಗಿರ್ತಕ್ಕಂಥ ರಜತ್ ಕುಮಾರ್ ಅವರೇ, ಮೆಲ್ಬರ್ಟ್ ಡಿಸೋಜಾರ್ ಅವರೇ, ಪ್ರಜ್ಞಾ ಯೋಗೇಶ್ ಭಟ್ರ ಅವರು ಹಾಗೂ ನೆರೆದಿರ್ತಕ್ಕಂಥ ಎಲ್ಲ ನನ್ನ ಯುವ ಮಿತ್ರರೇ, ಬಹುಶಃ ನನ್ನ ಮೊದಲಿಗೆ ಮಾತಾಡಿರ್ತಕ್ಕಂಥ ನನ್ನ ದೃಷ್ಟಿಯಲ್ಲಿ ಇಬ್ಬರು ಇವತ್ತು ಕೇಂದ್ರ ಬಿಂದುಗಳಾಗಿರ್ತಕ್ಕಂಥ ಅತಿಥಿಗಳು ಬಹುಶಃ ನನಗಿನ್ನ ವಯಸ್ಸಿನಲ್ಲಿ ಚಿಕ್ಕವರಾಗಿರ್ತಾರೆ ಅನ್ನೋದು ನಿಕಟವಾಗಿ ನಾನು ಹೇಳಬಲ್ಲೆ. ಶನಾಯಿಯವರು ಕೇಳ್ತಿದ್ರು, ಯಾವ ಕ್ಲಾಸ್ನಲ್ಲಿ, ಇನ್ ವಿಚ್ ಕ್ಲಾಸ್ ಆರ್ ವಿಚ್ ಕ್ಯಾಟಗರಿ ಡು ಐ ಬಿಲಾಂಗ್, ವೆದರ್ ಐ ಆಮ್ ಯೂತ್ ಆರ್ ಐ ಆಮ್ ಎ ಓಲ್ಡ್ ಪರ್ಸನ್. Probably appropriate thing. You are too young to be called a youth. I cannot say too old to be called old. You are also young to be called old. However, whatever it could be, if you are young at heart, that is all that matters, I suppose. You can gel with any age. Well, I am more of a, much of a more serious speaker rather than what my predecessors have done. And I am not cut out for that sort of thing. I may not gel that with student friends. I am a more, that is how I have been all along. I'm really more of a serious personality. Probably till people get to know me, they used to dread to approach me. I'm sorry, I cannot correct it at this age. And that's what I am, and I wish to have my originality. First of all, as I have been since my coming over here, I am 3 months old in the university. Maybe a familiar face to our people on the campus see me day in and day out at very odd hours and at very odd places. As I have told you, I have come here to Mangalore University by choice and not by chance. As I have been appealing to my esteemed colleagues, here also, once again, I make a sincere appeal to my chairman, Mr. Ishwar. It's very thankful on your part to have given me a bouquet of flowers. With dutiful respects, I have accepted it. But at the same time, I make my appeal again here. Next time when I come for any function or any function is organized by your department, I would be more than doubly happy if you could give me that in the form of a sapling. ಯಾವುದಾದ್ರೂ ಒಂದು ಸಣ್ಣ ಸಸಿಯನ್ನು ಕೊಡಿ. ನಿಮ್ಮೆಲ್ಲರಿಗೂ ಭಾರವಾದರೆ ಆ ಭಾರನ ನಾನು ಹೊರಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಸಿದ್ಧ ಇದ್ದೇನೆ. ನಿಮ್ಮೆಲ್ಲರಿಗೂ ತಗೊಂಡೋಗಿ ಅದು ಎಲ್ಲಿಯೂ ನೆಡಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಜಾಗ ಇಲ್ಲದಿದ್ದರೆ ನನ್ನ ಹತ್ರ ಜಾಗವೂ ಇದೆ. ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಮೈ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಅಪೀಲ್ ವಿಚ್ ಐ ಮೇಡ್. ಐ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಆಲ್ರೆಡಿ ಮೇಡ್ ಎ commitment towards this effect as a student of the subject. I come from the environmental engineering background. Apart from the love for the subject, once I landed here, I have made a task which is cut out for me. Mangalore University has been making giant strides in almost more than one fields. My young friends, I wish to share with you, probably some to some it may be a repetition. Mangalore University has the unique achievement of being rated as the number 3rd best university in terms of environmental yardstick, that is the green matrix. Mangalore University is rated as number 3rd best in the country. Now you can clap. If you really feel so. On the global scale, we are number 231. My immediate task when I got this news, I took this upon as something that is there in the offering for me to see that within a time frame, Mangalore University should be at the apocal, that is the number one. Why is it that we have achieved number three and not number one? In that sphere, my task is cut out. Hence my appeal to my esteemed colleagues in the departments and my young friends sitting in front of me. It is only with a cumulative cooperation with your good selves that I would be able to achieve, if any, to see that Mangalore University becomes number one. So this is a clear message. I was wondering why, what were the reasons for me to get the third place. There are many other factors which influence for the number one position. And my engineering background comes to me very, very handy. And to that, I am up to the task. And I have already sent a circular to this, that this should be a green campus. And this should be a zero waste or a zero discharge campus. If I have to achieve that, to be a successful campaigner in my endeavor, I appeal to my young friends here. We have already have had a couple of events in the form of NSS camps and various other Swachh Bharat camps here on the campus. Rather than making it mandatory at the helm, being at the helm of affairs, I wish to carry along with you with an openness. You should become a part. We are a part of the environment, and environment is never a part of us. We are a part of environment. To put it in my own terms, I see a number of sponsorship, and that's good, says that reflects well that being students of commerce, you are fairly comfortable. I don't know whether you people study in terms of, heard the word as intangible loss, a loss which is not measurable in terms of commons. Could it be direct or indirect? Environment is always a part of our life. My friends, I wish to share, because the other two people were much younger to me. My parents gave me the best of schooling. I had the best of opportunities while I was at Bangalore. But I am sure that the present generation do not live to have that enjoyment. I am sure. The Bangalore that I have seen as a small young boy or a student like you is never to come back.
shall never come back. And Bangalore today is making news for the wrong reasons globally. Probably when I was on a professional work, I was associated with that Belandur lake, which is making name not only on WhatsApp or whatever it could be. They had even reported that there is snow in Bangalore because of Belandur, which was sarcastic, ironical. That was only nothing but froth, nothing but a polluted froth which was emanating because we have bombarded the environment. I have the experience now when I go back to Bangalore, probably once a month or later, once I land in Bangalore, I have the experience of having cough, cold, and other things. But here in Bangalore, you are really blessed, I say. It's a God's gift. Do you want Bangalore also to be one, Mangalore also to be another Bengaluru? Would you want it to be like that? My young friends? Do you want Bangalore or Mangaluru? Thank you. Then probably something is cut out for all of us. Something is cut out for all of you, because we have got what is called as an environmental impact assessment, which is basically a tool which is used in my subjects as a yardstick to learn from other people's mistake. So you have a lot to learn from other people's mistake from Bangalore. And I, for one, don't want to give scope for those very same mistakes to be committed here in this campus. That is the reason I have envisaged that this should be the green campus, probably the best university campus on the green index within a time frame. Shall we achieve this? Mangalore University should set a different benchmark for all of the universities to boast that it is the greenest and the best campus in terms of environmental quality. I am disappointed that I don't have a responsive youth. I again reiterate that I am disappointed that I don't have a responsive youth. Is that clap for making this a greener campus or what? Thank you. Thank you. We shall together achieve, make this a better place. Because probably at my age now, I need not bother or care, but it is an obligation that what is it that we have left for our youth. I have had my best days at Bangalore. And I don't want you people to have Bangalore. You have a beautiful career of next 40 years. It is our obligation to see that you have a better enjoyment, as I was entitled to. It is your bounden right, for which we have to have been here in front of you speaking to you. Though my parents were too little educated in terms of a degree, But in terms of wisdom, they have imparted and inculcated in me a personality which they are no way inferior to any PhDs or number of PhDs. And for whatever I am today, I owe it to my parents and my alma mater. My everyday experience as a student is very vivid. Just as those people, my other speakers have given, shared their experiences. I know I am making you impatient, because being a teacher, I am sure that once you are in front of the stage, usually I used to do my classes at 8 o'clock or 8:30, I used to trouble my students. Though it used to start at 10, they would be there at 10 o'clock, 8 o'clock to attend my classes. And once being a teacher, probably I'd be also swayed or carried away by the time. A small experience. I was in my 5th standard. My parents were able to afford a very good schooling for me, even in those days, probably in 60s. I was in one of the best schools of Bangalore then. One day, when I got out of the car, I walked past an elder. And I went about 5 or 6 steps in front, and then I was summoned or called. She was the head nurse of the school. She called me back and said, "You don't have respect to wish a very good morning to your elders." That is yet imprinted in my mind even today. That is the sort of schooling we had. We had moral science in our classes, I think every week. Today I doubt very much there are moral science, and I'm not here one to teach moral science or anything. You people are well read. Probably your IQs are better than mine. I'm not here to advise, but I could only suggest. You are the best judge for yourself. You people know what is right. You people know what is wrong. It is your wisdom which carries you forward. I have taken probably more than what I should. I wish the organizers of this celebration's magnum all the success and all the best. I hope that this comes out every year and year, that we have something new to look forward in terms of innovativeness. Innovativeness in its own way, in your own way, so that Mangalore University, the flagship, is steadfast in its all-round holistic accomplishments, for which you are the tools and the ambassadors. I thank the organizers for having given me this opportunity to be with you and share with you. I hope you have an enjoyable evening. Thank you. Wish you all the best.
Thank you so much, sir, for your presidential remarks. As a token of gratitude to Professor B.S. Nagendra Prakash for the time and valuable input he had shared with us all today, I request Professor Ishwara P. to offer a memento to Professor B.S. Nagendra Prakash, Registrar, Mangalore University. Thank you so much, sir. As a token of love and appreciation, I request Professor B.S. Nagendra Prakash to place a memento to Dr. Priya Barlal, chief guest. I request Professor B.S. Nagendra Prakash to place a token of gratitude to Mr. Amrit Shenan as an effort of appreciation. Thank you, sir. As all good things come to an end in ordinary life, we hardly realize that we receive a great deal more than we give, and that it is only with gratitude that life becomes rich. May I request Mr. Abhinandan Kular, Faculty Coordinator of Commerce Association, Bangalore University, to
the honor and my privilege of proposing vote of thanks. First of all, I thank our Honorable Register Professor B.N. Nagendra Prasad for presiding over this function. Thank you, sir.
I'm not to be misread. I am Nagendra Prakash.
Sorry. Professor V.N. Nagendra Prakash for presiding this function. Thank you, sir. I also thank Dr. Priya Barlal for accepting our invitation and sharing her thoughts with us. Thank you, madam. I extend my warm thanks to Mr. Amrit Shenan for being guest of honor and for his valuable support. Thank you, sir. I express my heartfelt thanks to our chairman, Professor Ishwar P., for all his support and guidance in organizing Magnum 2008. Thank you, sir. I thank you all the teaching faculty for their support throughout, and also thank all the participants, research scholars and non-teaching staff for being with us. I thank teaching staff for being with us, and I thank all the media persons who are covering this wonderful function, and at last but not the least, I thank all the students for conducting this wonderful Magnum 2018. Conclusively, I thank one and all present here. Thank you.
Thank you. agriculture, secondary sector, industry, third sector, service sector. We have to banking sector, service sector, and medical sector. Third one, social and cultural sector, equality among all religions, ethics and morality. Three thoughts of my great person Mahatma Gandhi ji, see no evil, speak no evil, hear no evil. Fourth one, technological environment, environmental sustainability, eco-friendly use of positive side of technology, no water pollution, no soil pollution, no air pollution. Swachh Bharat Abhiyan, clean and smart city. Our nation song is best suitable for this theme. The first one, vision of India, the world leader. A leader should know how to manage failure. This sentence is said by the great personality Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam. Learning use creativity. Creativity leads to thinking. Thinking leads to knowledge. Knowledge gives idea. Commit focus goal. Our goal is vision of India, the world leaders. So anything is possible. Should work with integrity and succeed with integrity. Our future is in our hands. Dedicating our life for our nation. Nation building. Our dream can definitely come true. First thing, we have to dream for it. And our dream is vision of India, the world leader. Never give up. Thank you, one and all. Jai Hind, Jai Karnataka.
The time taken by this team is 3 minutes.
Study of Sanskrit has to be encouraged. However, the various status of India are still disadvantaging, discouraging and discriminating education in Sanskrit at school, college, university level. Sanskrit learning has been stopped in many schools in want of teachers and funds. Ayurveda, which is a science of life with a holistic approach to health and personalized medicine. Ayurveda, the traditional Indian medical system, remains the most ancient and living traditions with a sound philosophical and experimental basis. Undoubtedly, popularity of the Ayurveda system of medicine lagging behind as the majority of the global population prefers modern medicines. Sculpture. Indian sculpture, these cultural traditions, forms and styles of civilizations of the Indian subcontinent. Sculpture, who was the favorite medium of the artistic expression on the Indian subcontinent. Women entrepreneur. If by strength is meant moral, then woman is the imaged man's super care. We need to improve the status of women, and the promotion of the women's roles in the development are no longer seen merely as issues of human rights. The rate of their inclusion in business world is very low than the expected rate. Hence, women participation in the entrepreneurial activities is less than requirement of the fast growth of India. Embroidery in India. Embroidery in India includes dozens of embroidery styles that vary by regions and clothing styles. Designs in India, embroidery are performed. Agriculture. It is said to be agriculture is a backbone of Indian economy. Agriculture is a backbone of the Indian economy. Yes, because 75% of India's population depends on the agriculture. Now, it has come too late that India's economic growth is not keeping the expectation because its agricultural growth is lagging behind. Yes, if India concentrates and goes one step forward by taking improvised action also in these sectors, then undoubtedly the dream India the world leader definitely come true. If your actions inspires others to dream more, learn more, do more and become more, then you are a leader. Thank you.